E63 4matic. This is the amazing 63 with the nice down pipes. And now this we are fixing. Now Ryan, he's welding the new flanges. This is how it looks like. And this is, where is the this is how that looks like. So next time, to be more easy to remove it in the future, for any reason. This is the transmission, 722.9. What in hell is that? Ah, this don't catch up fire, eh? This is 722.9, the 4matic. We can see here we're stepping the bearings that they have a wear, and it's a good chance, you know, to change the bearings since we open it. The clutches, they are in disaster condition because some clutches that looks like brand new, some other clutches that looks like it's burned, it's black color. Some clutches, they have the Mercedes logo on it, some other has one different brand. What can I say? These are the rest of the parts. Here you can see that somebody cleaned the dual clutch, the converter. It looks like they sanded it or what, I don't have a clue what they did. That's the main pump. This for the front differential, and this one. Also the bearings here, you can see that they are not in very good shape. And since we open it, we're gonna change this to be healthy. Solenoid housing. We found the guy who's have a problem. Why has a problem with the transmission? This bearing, it's coming here, like that, like this. These two pieces was stuck inside here. And one second, please. And this one, see how it is? This one, it's missing one piece here on this spot. Here it's bent. That's why it's very critical to fix your start assembly, the transmission. You can open it as you like, if you open it carefully. But when you are assembling, when it's come the time to put by again, you have to put the bell housing down, and then you start building from down to up, so to don't come out any bearing, don't slip, let us say, and step in another in different position. By the way, they opened the transmission, this specific transmission, they opened it 4 times before. This is what he said, the customer, as per the customer. This is the bottom section here. I'm advising you to don't open this one. And if you open, you have to be extra careful to don't lose any check valve, like this one. There is one here, there is one here, and there is another one here, front. There are three. Sometimes this one is sticking on the plate. And from this side, there are valves, and there is also some bolts that's like a check valve. It's working like this ball. Don't ask me, I don't remember where it's going each one. There are plenty. And don't ask me what's doing each valve. I don't have a clue. See how it's here. To open this one, I'm opening just only for cleaning. Carefully, to don't lose the order. If I lose the order, I have to open the computer to see where it's going each one. It's a headache. Fortunately, I didn't lose the order up to now. To open this one, because from the upper piece here, you have only two and three plastic valves. There is one, two, another one here. I pull it out. No, I didn't pull it out. One, two, and then there is another one here, three. Let me pull one out to see how it looks like. Yeah, it'll come out. Doesn't want to come out. Okay, it's this stupid shit that if you push inside, it's going inside. So, this one, how you are doing it? You have it like that. So, when it's come the time to open it, you keep the plate. This is where it's coming, the transmission oil filter. That means when you open it from down, you see this spot here. This is what, when you open the transmission oil pan, you see this piece here. So this has to look down, and then when you open it, this piece, you're gonna get it with the gasket together to don't fall out. And when it's come the time to open it, slide it like that, So this small stupid shit, sorry for my language, these small pieces, they're not gonna go away. You're not gonna lose the order. We need some couple of bolts, also for front, because aluminum is not like the 722.6, the older models that has, it's not aluminum, it's iron. Some bearings, some clutches, actually all the set, and most probably we're gonna put the Wastex set of clutches. They're much better, can handle more abuse than this. The gasket, the main gasket here, if you see, 1 second, don't throw it down everything. The main, leave it there, okay. The main gasket, you can see that somebody scratched it too many times. I don't know what they was thinking. There are some scratches here and there. Like they clean it, but I don't know with what. Yeah, they will gonna put a new one, this one. We're not gonna leave the old one. Opa. And except of this, okay, finish the video with this one. This is the 722.9 transmission. This house looks like inside. What else? When you open the rear cover here, you see the marks here. Take a look at the marks here. They put the screwdriver or what? This is the drain plug for the rear section here back, and they put this bolt. Go figure out. Alright. Yes. So 722.9 for 4matic. Housing is different, everything is different. Be careful if you open it. My advice for the solenoid housing here, if you don't have to, don't open it. You can see also the usually I'm gonna open to check these things. This is for the selector, for the gear selector, the path. This is coated, and you can see the coat. If it has any scratch here or scratch here, this has effect. And there are also here inside, there is here inside, has a spring inside. You have to be careful how you're gonna open it. The same thing from this side, I'm talking about this. You have to be extra careful how you're gonna remove it, and you have to be extra careful how you're gonna insert it again inside. And again, only if it's necessary, you're gonna open that. You have one in a million to have a problem on this spot. Usually you don't have a spot. You don't have a problem, sorry. Now I open it just only to make a video, that's why. Otherwise, honestly, I didn't want to open it. All right, finish the story with the 722.9 4matic. Now we are fixing also the flange. Let's see again the beautiful piece here, there, what they did on the exhaust. Another one thing that I was thinking about that, about the bypass, that what they did on the 4-cylinder and the number 8 cylinder, that they put it direct on the downpipe. You're gonna do that. Actually, never gonna do that. But I cannot. If, let us say, you make a tune on the car, all right, and you are asking from the turbocharger 1.3 bar of boost, and one when the wastegate is fully open, it's wide open, the wastegate, and you see that it cannot stay at 1.3 bar where you what you are asking, and it's coming, let's say, 2 bar the pressure, that means you are spinning too fast the turbocharger. So you have to find a way how to bypass the gases out of the turbo, of the hot side of the turbocharger. One way is to put external wastegate, bigger. But in this case, you don't have a space to do it. Where are you gonna put it? So, but definitely you're not gonna do something like that. I don't know, what can I say? Then, finish the story. Finish, third time, I'm saying again. Done, this is the transmission, this is the downpipes. We're gonna finish, we're gonna fix this one. I don't know where he make the tune. It's not our business is the transmission. He came from the transmission here. So, yeah, and also they didn't use new nut, but this is a drop in the ocean, according to the rest, whatever has the car. Then, I have to show you one engine, 1,300 horsepower. 1,300 horsepower on the flywheel, guys. If you see this engine, what? I have to show you the engine first, that's why. Wait. See this engine. This amazing engine. You like it? Take a look. I was have to see this engine. 10 years. Take a look at an engine. This is good for blender. take a look. This is, if you said to me somebody that was 600 cubic centimeters, I'm gonna believe it. This engine, it's for this car, for Fiat 500. We changed the engine, because this engine has a problem with the head gasket. And actually, to be honest with you, I don't have a clue why if it has only head gasket problem, because it has always misfire and always coming wet one spark plug. We didn't bother to open the engine. It's not worth it. If it has a crack, a cylinder head or whatever, so we drop inside one used engine. Yeah, that's the too much power. Too much power. You know, amazing. See, it's Fiat. Fiat, you can say Fiat like a FF. No, I'm not gonna say that. I'm not gonna say what other world it's coming with a. It's like, no, I'm gonna say that because you're gonna think that I'm swearing. Funeral! Like a funeral, exactly. That's it. Thank you very much, guys. See ya.